Afghanistan's Taliban authorities and neighboring Iran said on Sunday deadly clashes between their border security forces had subsided, with both the sides engaging in talks to ease tensions. The skirmishes erupted in the Afghan border province of Nimroz Saturday, killing two Iranian security forces and a Taliban border guard, officials in both countries said. Both the sides traded blame for the heavy exchange of cross-border gunfire, escalating Iran's tensions with Afghanistan amid a dispute over water resources. Sunday, the Iranian state-run IRNA news agency quoted a senior official as saying that the situation is under control in the conflict zone near the Sisauli border post in Iran's Sistan-Balochistan province. Alireza Marhamati, the deputy provincial governor, said that local Iranian and Afghan officials have held negotiations on the cause of the clashes and agreed to continue their talks. A spokesman for the Afghan Interior Affairs Ministry said in a statement that his government does not want to fight with its neighbors and insisted Iranian forces started the conflict, prompting Afghan border forces to retaliate. Turkey's President Recep Tayyip Erdogan was seen handing out cash to supporters after casting vote in the second round of presidential elections on Sunday. The incumbent head of state handed out banknotes worth 200 liras each and shook hands with supporters who were lined up outside the door, Reuters reported. Earlier on May 14, before casting ballot in the first round of presidential polls, President Erdogan was seen handing out cash to kids. Turkish law bars candidates from campaigning on the election day. Country's election oversight authorities are yet to take note of Erdogan's cash handout act. Meanwhile, on Sunday, cheers also erupted among supporters of Erdogan's rival, Kemal Kılıçdaroğlu, as he arrived to cast his vote in the country's election runoff on Sunday. Supporters chanted, "People's President Kılıçdaroğlu," as the leader of Turkey's opposition came out of the polling station waving to the crowd. While Erdogan has defied early opinion polls and came out ahead in the first round, Kılıçdaroğlu's supporters are holding out hope for a change in the country's leadership. A win for Erdogan will extend his rule into the third decade. China's first indigenously built passenger aircraft, C919, on May 28, successfully completed its first commercial flight, marking its official entry into the civil aviation market as part of the country's effort to compete with Western rivals like Boeing and Airbus. Its first homegrown jetliner with mass commercial potential would also cut the country's reliance on foreign technology as ties with the West deteriorate. The first commercial flight of C919 from Shanghai to Beijing is carried out by the state-run China Eastern Airlines. China Eastern Airlines flight MU9191 rose into the skies above Shanghai Hongqiao Airport on Sunday morning. The plane carried 128 passengers on board. The flight time between Shanghai and Beijing was about 2 hours and 25 minutes, the state-run Xinhua news agency reported. The plane was greeted with a water salute after touching down in Beijing Capital International Airport at 12:31 p.m. on May 28, the report said. As Ukrainian capital Kyiv prepared to celebrate the anniversary of its founding on Sunday, Russia unleashed multiple waves of airstrikes on Kyiv overnight in what officials said appeared to be the largest drone attack on the city since the start of the war. Kyiv's mayor Vitaly Klitschko said that a man died when drone wreckage fell near a petrol station while a woman was injured. Ukraine's Air Force said that it downed 52 out of the 54 Russia-launched drones, calling it a record attack. The 54 attack drones were launched from the regions of Bryansk and Krasnodar in Russia, said the Air Force, adding that 52 were destroyed. The pre-dawn attacks came on the last Sunday of May when the capital celebrates Kyiv Day, the anniversary of its official founding 1,541 years ago. The day is typically marked by street fairs, live concerts and special museum exhibitions, plans for which have been made this year too, but on a smaller scale. Today, the enemy decided to congratulate the people of Kyiv on Kyiv Day with the help of their deadly UAVs, unmanned aerial vehicles, Serhiy Popko, the head of Kyiv's military administration, said.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.